So next topic we are going to see is transmission media. The transmission medium can be defined as anything that can carry information from a source to a destination. So what is transmission medium? A transmission medium can be defined as anything that can carry information from source to destination. Now, transmission media are actually located below the physical layer. Where our transmission media is located, the transmission media is located below the physical layer and are directly controlled by the physical layer. This transmission media are directly controlled by the physical layer. Transmission media. Transmission media, there are two types. One is guided transmission media. Another one, unguided transmission media. The guided transmission media is a wired transmission media, and unguided transmission media is a wireless transmission media. This guided transmission media is divided into three. That is, first one, twisted pair cable, then coaxial cable, and fiber optic cable. So in the wired or guided transmission media, we are having twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, and fiber optic cable. But in unguided or wireless transmission media, we are having free space. So the guided media are those that provide a conduit from one device to another, include twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, and fiber optic cable. There will be a wire or a path. A signal traveling along any of this media is directed and contained by the physical limits of the medium. So a signal traveling along these media means either it may be a twisted pair or coaxial or optical cable. So the signals traveling through these media is that directed and contained by the physical limits of the medium. Twisted pair and coaxial cable use metallic conductors that accept and transport signal in the form of electric current. The twisted pair and coaxial cable are having which copper. Okay. Optical fiber is a cable that accepts and transport signals in the form of light. But the twisted pair and coaxial cable, it will transport signal in the form of electric current. And optical fiber transport signals in the form of light. First one, twisted pair cable. A twisted pair cable consists of two conductors. Normally, the conductors are made of copper with some plastic insulation twisted together. So it is called a twisted pair. One of the wires is used to carry the signal to the receiver, and other is used only as a ground reference. So you're having two conductors. One will carry the signal and other is used as a ground reference. The receiver uses the difference between these two. Okay. The receiver will use the difference. In addition to the signal sent by the sender on one of the wires, interference and crosstalk may affect both wires and create unwanted signal. So through the cable, twisted cable, you will be sending only the signal, but due to the transmission, there will be some noise and crosstalk that may affect the signals. Okay. So this is a twisted pair. So two cables twisted each other. Okay. So it is having insulator in the outer. It is having an insulator inside. You are having a copper conductor. Next, if two wires are parallel, the effect of this unwanted signal is not the same in both the wires. So if the wires are parallel, the effect of the unwanted signal is not same in both the wires because they are at different locations relative to the noise or crosstalk. So one will be closer, another one will be farther. This result in a difference at the receiver. So if you're not twisting and if the two wires are parallel, the effect of the unwanted signal is not same in both wires because they are at different location relative to the noise or crosstalk. So this result in a difference at the receiver. By twisting the pairs, this balance is maintained. Twisting make it probable that both the wires are equally affected by external influences. Okay, since you are twisting, both the wires are equally affected by the noise. This means that the receiver, which calculates the difference between two, receives no unwanted signals. The unwanted signals are almost cancelled out. Okay, so this is a unshielded twisted pair cable and this is a shielded twisted pair cable. There are two type of cable. One is shielded twisted pair and the one is unshielded twisted pair. So here you are having a metal shield, so it is called shielded twisted pair. So here you are not having that shield, so it is called unshielded twisted pair. So this shielded twisted pair, it was developed by IBM. So this cable will be having a metal foil or braided mesh covering that encases the two pair of insulated conductors. So above the two twisted wires, you are having one what? One metal foil or mesh. So this metal casing improves the quality of the cable by preventing the penetration of noise or crosstalk, but it is bulkier and expensive. So adding this metal casing improves the quality of the cable by preventing the penetration of noise or crosstalk, but it is bulkier and more expensive. The EIA has developed standards to classify unshielded twisted pair into 7 categories. There are 7 categories of unshielded twisted pair. Okay. These categories are determined by the cable quality. And one is the lowest quality and 7 is the highest quality. So each category, it is used for some specific use. So here are the 7 categories of twisted pair, unshielded twisted pair cables. Okay, first one, category 1, unshielded twisted pair used in telephone. It is having a data rate of less than 0.1 megabits per second. So next one, unshielded twisted pair originally used in T-lines. It is having a data rate of less than 2 megabits per second. Similarly, the category 3, it is an improvement over category 2 and it is having a data rate of 10 megabits per second and it is used in LANs. Similarly, all the other thing. Okay, each one will be having a different data rate and it will be used for some specific applications. Next one, connectors. The connectors that is used for unshielded twisted pair is RJ45. RJ stands for registered jack. What is RJ? RJ is nothing but the registered jack. So RJ45 is a keyed connector. Keyed connector means you can insert only one way. So this is a connector. Okay. This is a RJ45 connectors. Application. The twisted pair cables are used in telephone lines to provide voice and data channels. The local loop, the line that connects the subscriber to the central telephone office commonly consists of unshielded twisted pair cables. So usually the local loop line in our telephone network that connects the subscriber to the central telephone office will be having unshielded twisted pair. The digital subscriber line will also use this unshielded twisted pair. Similarly, the LAN such as 10 base T and 100 base T also use this unshielded twisted pair. Next one is coaxial cable. So coaxial cables carries signal of high frequencies. The twisted pair cable, it will carry signal of lower frequency, but this coaxial cable, it will carry signal of higher frequency. The coaxial cable will be having a central core conductor of solid or stranded wire, and it is having an insulated sheath over it, and again it is encased in an outer conductor of metal foil or a combination of two. The outer metallic wrapping serves as a shield against noise and as a second conductor which completes the circuit. This outer conductor is again enclosed in an insulating sheath, and the whole cable is protected by a plastic cover. So this is coaxial cable. So initially you are having inner conductor, above that there is an insulator, again an outer shield, metallic covering, again an insulator, again a plastic cover. This is nothing but your coaxial cable. So coaxial cable are categorized by their radio government ratings. RG is nothing but radio government ratings. Each RG number denotes a unique set of physical specification. The physical specification of the wire gauge of inner conductor, its thickness, the type of the insulator used, the construction of the shield, and the size and type of outer casing. So you're having three categories of coaxial cable: RG59, which is having an impedance of 75 ohm and it is used for cable TV, and RG58, and it is having an impedance of 50 ohm and it is used in thin ethernet, that is 10 base 2. And next one, RG11, it is having an impedance of 50 ohm and it is used in thick ethernet. Next one is B and C connectors, that is Bay 1 Neil Concealment Connector. So it will connect the coaxial cable to devices. There are three types of connectors: BNC connector. This is BNC connector. It is used to connect the end of the cable to a device. Next, BNC T connector. It is used in Ethernet. And last one, BNC terminator, which is used to prevent the reflection of signal. This is BNC connector, BNC terminator, and BNC T connector. So BNC means Bay 1 Neil Main Concealment Connector. Application: coaxial cable was used in analog telephone networks. It was used in digital telephone networks where a single coaxial cable in telephone networks has largely been replaced today by fiber optic cable. So this cable TV networks also use coaxial cable. The disadvantage of coaxial cable is attenuation is much higher in coaxial cable than in twisted pair cable. So fiber optic cable. A fiber optic cable is made of glass or plastic and transmits signal in the form of light. Light travels in straight line as long as it is moving through a single uniform substance. If a ray of light traveling through one substance suddenly enters into another substance, the ray changes direction. The critical angle is an angle of incidence that produces a 90 degree angle of refraction. What is critical angle? A critical angle is an angle of incidence that produces 90 degree angle of refraction. So here we are going to see the bending of the light ray. First, you are passing the ray. Here, the angle of incidence is less than critical angle. So refraction is taking place. Next one, angle of incidence is equal to critical angle, but again refraction, but it is passing near the interface. Next one, the angle of incidence greater than critical angle. Here, reflection is taking place. If the angle of incidence is less than critical angle, the ray refracts and move closer to the surface, If the angle of incidence is equal to the critical angle, light bends along the surface. Next one, if the angle is greater than the critical angle, the ray reflects and travel again in the denser substance. So the critical angle is a property of the substance and its value differs from one substance to another. What is critical angle? A critical angle is a property of substance and its value differs from one substance to another. This is fiber optic cable. It is having a core, then a cladding, then a buffer and a jacket. So this is also a fiber optic cable. This is inner, you'll be having a core, then you are having a cladding, then you are having a plastic buffer. Above the plastic buffer, you are having a DuPont caliber for strength. And this is the outer jacket. So the outer jacket is made up of plastic or Teflon. The inside the jacket, you are having a Kevlar strand to strengthen the cable. Usually this Kevlar material, it is strands. It is used for bulletproof dresses. So below the Kevlar material, you are having a buffer, plastic buffer. Then after the buffer, you are having a cladding, then core. So here in the optical fiber, you are having core and cladding, and the light is passing through a optical fiber through the core. It is passing by total internal reflection. There are propagation mode. First, there is two mode, that is multi-mode and single mode. In multi-mode, you are having two things. One is step index and next one is graded index. So this is multi-mode step index. Okay. So it will, the ray will follow different paths. So next one is multi-mode graded index. See, in single mode, the light will pass through only one way. Okay. Here many paths it is taking. Here it is taking only one path. That is the main difference between single mode and multi-mode. So multi-mode means multiple beams from a light source move through the core in different paths. Step index. This is step index. Core density is constant from the center to the edges. So in step index, the core density is constant. In graded index, the core density will be varying. It is highest at the center and it will be gradually reducing. Then single mode. It has much small core and the light ray propagate through a single path. Okay. So here the light ray propagate through a single path and here the light ray propagate through multiple paths. So this is multi-mode step index. This is multi-mode graded index. This is single mode. So in step index, the density of the core remains constant from center to the edges. A graded index fiber is one having varying density. The core is having varying density. The density is highest at the center and decreases gradually to the edge. Single mode uses only step index fiber. Multimode fiber uses both step index as well as graded index. So application. The fiber optic cable is the backbone network of many networks. Why? Because it is having wide bandwidth. The SONET is also using fiber optic cable. So now most of the TV companies, they are using optical fiber. Okay. So local area networks such as 100 base FX, it will be using fiber optic. So next, connectors. The type of connectors we are using in this fiber optic is SC connector. SC connector is subscriber channel connector. It is used for cable TV. Next one, ST connector. ST connector is straight tip connector. It is used in connecting cable TV network devices. Next one is MT-RJ connector. MT means mechanical transfer. Registered jack connector. So the subscriber channel connector is used for cable TV. It uses a push-pull locking system. The straight tip connector is used for connecting cable to the networking devices. It uses bay onet locking system and it is more reliable than subscriber channel connector. Mechanical transfer RJ connector is a connector. Its size is same as registered jack 45. Advantages is it is having high bandwidth, less signal attenuation, immunity to this is advantages of fiber optics. Less signal attenuation, immunity to electromagnetic interference, resistance to corrosive materials, lightweight, greater immunity to tapping. Disadvantages is installation and maintenance, unidirectional light propagation, its cost, it is not flexible. Next one, unguided media. Unguided media is a wireless media. So unguided media transport electromagnetic waves without using a physical conductor. There is no physical conductor, but by using electromagnetic waves, we will be connecting. This type of communication is often referred to as wireless communication. So this is a spectrum from 3 kilohertz to 300 gigahertz. You're having radio wave and microwave communication. And from 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz, you're having infrared. So that in this radio wave is 3 kilohertz to 1 gigahertz and microwave is 1 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. So unguided signals can travel from the source to destination in several ways. That is ground propagation, sky propagation, and line of sight propagation. In ground propagation, radio waves travel through the lowest portion of the earth, that is close to earth. The low frequency signal emanate in all direction from the transmitting antenna and follow the curvature of the planet. Okay, so these signals will be coming in all direction from the antenna and it will follow the curvature of the earth. The distance, how much distance it is covering, it will depends upon the power of the signal. Greater the power, greater the distance. Next one is sky propagation. The high frequency radio waves radiate upward into the ionosphere. The sky propagation is through ionosphere. Why we are calling it is ionosphere means the particles exist as ions. So this type of transmission allows a greater distance. Next one is line or sight propagation. The line of sight propagation is a very high frequency signals are transmitted in straight lines directly from antenna to antenna. Antenna must be directional and it must face each other and either tall enough or close enough together not to be affected by the curvature of earth. The line of sight propagation is a tricky one because radio transmission cannot be completely focused. So the first one is a ground propagation. It can be used below 2 megahertz and next one is the sky propagation from 2 to 30 megahertz and next one is line of sight propagation that is above 30 megahertz. So this is nothing but the different frequency band. That is very low frequencies from 3 to 30 kilohertz and it is used for ground propagation. And its application is long range radio navigation and low frequency is 3 to 300 kilohertz. It is propagation is ground propagation, radio beacons and navigational locators. Next one, middle frequency, it is 300 kilohertz to 3 megahertz and it is sky propagation and it is AM radio. Next one is high frequency is 3 to 30 megahertz. It is sky propagation and it is used in citizen band and ship or aircraft communication. Next one is very high frequency, that is from 30 to 300 megahertz and it is used in sky and line of sight propagation and it is also used in FM radio and TV. Next one, ultra high frequency, it is 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz. It is used in line of sight and it is used in telephones, pagers and satellite. Next one is super high frequency, that is 3 to 30 gigahertz. It is used in satellite communication and extra high frequency, it is 30 to 300 gigahertz. It is used in radar and satellite. So electromagnetic waves ranging in the frequency 3 kilohertz to 1 gigahertz are normally called as radio waves. And waves ranging in the from 1 to 300 gigahertz are microwaves. Radio waves are omnidirectional. When an antenna transmits radio waves, they are propagated in all directions. So this means that sending and receiving antennas do not have to be aligned. So these are the three mode of wireless transmission, that is radio wave, microwave and infrared wave. So the sending antenna wave that can be received by the sending antenna sends waves, and that can be received by any receiving antenna. So here you are using a omnidirectional antenna. So radio waves use omnidirectional antenna that send out signals in all direction based on wavelength, strength and the purpose of transmission. We are having several type of antenna. So next one, microwaves. One from 300 GHz is called microwaves, and microwaves are unidirectional. When an antenna transmits microwaves, they can be narrowly focused. The sending and receiving antennas needs to be aligned. Unidirectional property has an advantage. So a pair of antenna can be aligned without interfering with another pair of aligned antenna. Some characteristics of microwave is microwave propagation is line of sight. Very high frequency microwave cannot penetrate through walls. And disadvantage is if receivers are inside the building, we can't get it. So microwave band is relatively wide, that is 299 gigahertz. So by using this microwave, high data rate is possible. So we need permission from authorities to use the microwaves. So these are the type of antennas we are using, that is dish antenna and horn antenna. Next one is infrared. Infrared waves with the frequencies 300 GHz to 400 GHz can be used for short range. Infrared is used for short range communication. So infrared waves having high frequency cannot penetrate through walls. So advantages characteristics prevents interference between the system. So it prevents a interference. So we cannot use infrared waves outside a building because sun's rays contain infrared waves that can interfere with the communication. So we have completed the transmission media.